Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome yourselves back. My name is PGHD here at Josh, and today I'm bringing you another Battlefield 4 commentary. This is the second time I've had to do it because Audacity messed up my microphone, which is annoying. It selects my webcam, which is... I don't even know where the webcam is, so it was recording it absolutely awfully, and that is annoying as hell. But anyway, we are back with Sunday Talk. We're playing on the map Metro, which is so good. I've been waiting so long, and due to a lot of bugs in the game, I couldn't actually play Metro on Rush at all, and I couldn't get into the subway and all that, and it's just incredible. And this game was so fun to play, even though the clips are pretty short, and I've kept the video down to a reasonable size. You know, there is a lot I want to talk about regarding Battlefield, and enjoy the gameplay in the background. It starts off with some sniping with M40 and then moves on to some M416 gameplay, which I hope you guys enjoy. So anyway, let's get into the Sunday Talk. Now, Sunday Talk is just where I pretty much just pick a topic to talk about, and I talk about it on a Sunday. And today, unfortunately, for people who don't like rants, you might want to click off the video now, because this is going to be a rant. And the reason that I'm going to be ranting today is because Battlefield 4 is fucked. You heard it. You heard it here first. Nah, the game is really annoying, and I've had a lot of issues today, and it just aggravates me to the point where I'm just like, really, you know, really EA, really DICE, do you really have to mess it up that badly? And clearly they do. So basically what happened is there's a glitch on Xbox 360 only, I believe, which is kind of gay. And it's not PS3, so it's not because it's the older generation, it's just an Xbox thing. And basically when you load into a game, it would freeze on the main screen where it says like Metro, Firestorm, bloody bloody blah, 2014, what game mode it is. Gives you a list of what to do in Rush, Team Deathmatch, etc, etc. And it would freeze, and you couldn't hit the guide button because then it would freeze. It would freeze it completely. So you'd have to turn off your Xbox, reconnect, which... I'm not sure if it's just me, but Xbox 360 takes a long ass time to reconnect to Xbox Live. It takes for fucking ever to turn back on, and then you have to sign back in. Bloody bloody blah, jump back into the game and then get into another match. So that is annoying as hell. Now the way to fix that is basically to go into your hard drive on your Xbox. You've got to delete all the updates for the game apart from the title update, and then you have to clear your system cache and then jump back into the game. It will prompt you to do the latest title up, not the latest title update, the latest update slash patch, which is update 8. That is like 640 meg, which takes for freaking ever on my connection. My connection is a 1.5 down, 0.3 up, and that takes a long time. It takes like 2.5 hours to do that patch. So once that's done, it stops the freezing, and also the other glitch that it stops is where you'll spawn in and everything will be like tripping out, and it's exactly what it looked like when my graphics card to my computer broke and it just spazzed out the whole screen. And I thought that was what was happening to my Xbox, that it was going to blow up or something, but nope, it was the game's fault, which is absolutely brilliant. And also there is a couple of other glitches in the game, which there's one where you can fall out the map, which is just like, how that has not been patched is beyond me. And to be honest, like, you're about 1,000 meters below the map. I was on Caspian border, had an RPG, you couldn't even hit anyone. You couldn't like glitch out and cheat or anything because you're so far down. You parachute down to try and stop yourself or whatever, and it just like keeps you floating in midair, which makes no sense. Stupid ass glitch, and you have to redeploy and commit suicide. So that's absolutely awful, and you shouldn't have to really commit suicide because the game is completely broken, which again is unfair. Moving on, I do want to kind of give you guys a question. And the question of this video is going to be, do you feel that EA and DICE release DLC even though the game needs a patch? Basically, since the first DLC, since China Rising, you know, the game has been buggy as anything. Like, there's so much shit in the game. And I don't mean to just bash on it, because it is a really fun game. And the standard maps aren't too great, but with Second Assault, the game is beautiful. It's so good. You know, the game is really fun to play. It looks nice-ish on Xbox 360. But the bugs just ruin it completely. It really does put me on a downer when I jump on Battlefield 4 and, you know, the zero health glitch, which fortunately, thank you EA and DICE for fixing that, because that was ridiculous. But do you guys feel that they need to patch the game before releasing all this dumbass DLC, which no one really cares about? Because we'd all rather, I think most people would rather have a working game rather than loads of DLC. And also, I think if they are only going to make it this year, because all the DLC is due out before the summer, so that suggests that the new Battlefield will be coming out this year, they should have at least maybe release less DLC or just have focus on the game and gone back into that 2-year cycle. I know DICE aren't going to be working on the new Battlefield, I don't think, which sucks because personally I really do like DICE. I really have enjoyed Battlefield 3 and 4, which I have played. I even played a bit of Bad Company 2 last night, and DICE are an amazing company, so it is going to be sad to see them leave, and hopefully maybe the next one will be even better, maybe because it's changed companies that it will change and everything will be on the up. So I think for today, guys, that's going to be it. It's very quick. I did have a longer video, but you know, I don't think 7 minutes is, I think 7 minutes is too much for me now. I think a 5-6 minute commentary gets me through what I want to say and it doesn't stay too boring. So if you have watched the entire video, then leave a comment down below saying I'm awesome or something like that. I don't even care, to be honest. But if this video can hit 5 likes, guys, that would be amazing. And also, if you can subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll see you next week for episode 4 of Sunday Talk. See you later.